co-chair and distinguished delegates. Currently, 9 countries have possession of nuclear weapons, Russia included. After the fall of the USSR, the Russian Federation inherited over 30,000 weapons of mass destruction and took action to dismantle many. Now, Russia is in possession of 6,000 and they're in the process of dismantling around 1,500 more. The Russian Federation has decided to retain the right to use nuclear weapons but are committed to maintaining a nuclear warfare-free Earth. Youth can bring awareness to the effects of weapons of mass destruction. The youth can use communication platforms like social media to share their ideas on an international level to gain support from people who agree. Another way that the youth can be active within their state governments is to support leaders who are pro-disarmament and non-proliferation. If countries start to reduce their arsenals of nuclear weapons, then we can slowly reduce the fear of nuclear weapons worldwide. Thank you for your time and attention.
Delegates. Housing is a basic need. When you don't have adequate housing, you don't have any security in the middle of the night, which is probably not safe. Securing tenure means that if someone tries to get you kicked out of your house or if someone tries to threaten you, you can sue them. You should be able to live in your house without worrying that you can get evicted from your home. There are estimated to be 5 million people in Russia without a home. However, the Russian Constitution says that every citizen has to have a home. Nevertheless, Russia is trying to have housing be more affordable so that way more people can live in a home. The delegation of Russia suggests that if a country needs something that is used in adequate housing, such as wood, brick, and metal, they should give them the resources they need. That way, not as many people will suffer from inadequate housing. Thank you for your time and attention.
Thank you, Honorable Chairman and delegates. As Kofi Annan once said, extreme poverty anywhere is a threat to human security everywhere. The Ukraine-Russian conflict has affected global food security heavily in the past, geopolitically, economically, and militarily. The conflict in the Eurasian area has brought on global consequences of the decrease of grain production, which has skyrocketed grain prices in the global markets. Russia and Ukraine in the past have accounted for the majority of the world's exports of wheat and grains. Since Russia has been involved with Ukraine, the additional land will have more opportunities, technology, and resources to be developed. The delegation of Russia thinks that strengthening policies, establishing framework to measure and improve output, promoting modern agriculture approaches, diversifying sustainable agriculture research, and addressing inequalities in agriculture ecosystems will greatly contribute to a better agriculture and food system worldwide. Thank you for your time and attention.
Powerful bombs. Discrimination impacts technology
by the inability to use the internet and communications technology, which is known as the digital divide. It affects 52% of women and 42% of men worldwide. The Russian Federation uses the National Project for Science to monitor the development of science and technology. In addition, Russia shares technology with India, South Africa, and China. The delegation of Russia believes the international community can safely share technology by sharing information to help infrastructure. The delegation of Russia suggests that new technology be used to protect, monitor, and conserve progress and the community. Thank you for your time.
Thank you. Honor for sharing this with the delegates. The government of the Russian Federation is here to discuss child rights. As an old man, a Russian-born political activist once stated in 1931, no one has yet realized the wealth of sympathy, the kindness, and generosity hidden in the soul of a child. Many children worldwide are forced to live in certain harsh conditions. The child doesn't access to fundamental rights, their physical and intellectual development will be affected. Child rights violations include child labor, abuse, poverty, lack of education necessary for children. Unfortunately, 50 million Russians are currently living in poverty. This delegation believes that several strategies can help support this emerging problem, such as opening more schools so that children can get better education. Moreover, the government should create additional sustainable employment opportunities for youth. Children must feel safe, secure, and get access to shelter, food, clothing, and protection from harm. These solutions, child poverty could be reduced in Russia and worldwide. Thank you for your time and attention.
In 1965, the international community created a convention called UNESCO to eliminate all forms of racial discrimination. UNESCO created the Culture of Peace concept in 1992. The culture of peace is not only the absence of conflict, but also the emphasis on tolerance, opportunities, development, equality, freedom, and respect for themselves and others. By 2030, the delegation of Russia will upgrade sustainable energy services for all, in addition to working on educational initiatives for youth. Thank you for your time and attention.
Thank you, Honorable Chair. 1% can be very small depending on the context. In this context, 1% is the amount of global trade that landlocked developing countries, also known as LGCs, make up. There are 32 LGCs worldwide. This is because trade is very difficult for LGCs. They have high transport and transit costs, making it so that the further the country is, the costlier it is to transport resources. The Russian delegation believes that creating cheaper ways of transportation could help countries around the globe, especially LGCs. They could also improve their trade with surrounding countries, as it would affect their costs less. One final thing that can help lessen their trade costs is to create an economic region. This would let assets and assistance travel over borders without any restrictions. Thank you all for listening.
Thank you, members of the ISF. This resolution was put into motion when we split into the four subtopics: education, social media and other platforms, impact of youth, and weapons of mass destruction, small arms, and communication between countries. There was a lot of time, passion, effort, and work put into this resolution, but none of this would have been possible without the chair and, of course, my fellow delegates. Thank you.
We collaborated great. We were engaged in the work and listened to each other's ideas.